으뜸아, 안녕. 나는 너야. 15년 후. 미국 삶 적응하기 힘들지. 난 이해해. 그래도 난널 믿어. 넌 해낼 수 있을 거야. So anyway, now these words that I'm saying to you, you're probably not going to understand what I'm saying to you because you pretty much are just getting used to immigration. You just came to New York State from having been born and raised in South Korea for pretty much 10 years of your life. And now you're in this land which is so totally foreign to you. And I know you're undergoing culture shock, and there is this humongous language barrier. I know at this point you don't even really know alphabets all that well. Maybe you can say A, B, and C, but you don't really know what they are. You don't really know how to write ABCs. You don't even know alphabets, pretty much. So I know that you are my 10-year-old self. You have no idea what I'm saying to you right now. Don't understand because I'm speaking in English. But I'm speaking to you in English because, well, I know myself. I know you. And believe it or not, in 6 months' time, you're going to understand almost every word that I'm saying in this video. Maybe some words are going to be too hard and you're going to be pulling up your dictionary. But in 6 months' time, you're going to be fluent in English conversationally. I mean, your writing skills and your reading skills are gonna really suck. They're gonna be at third grade level, or second grade, or first grade level. I don't know. They're pretty horrible. I mean, understandably, you just immigrated to America. But in 6 months' time, it's going to be an unbelievable feeling of just pride and feeling like you accomplished something so huge. Because in 6 months' time, you're going to be able to talk to anyone you want in America and have a conversation with them about almost everything. I mean, you still can't read the. There's still some things you can't read and understand. Like I said, your reading comprehension skill is going to suck, and your writing skill is going to suck for quite some time. But in 6 months' time, that's all I'm saying. That's an amazing accomplishment. I think you are a brilliant, brilliant kid, which is something I can't say by myself now, but I think I look back to you. I look to you and who you become when you're 11, who you become when you're 12, up to when you're 14, from what you are now to you're 14 years old. I think you accomplished so much, and it amazes me that I was you, because you have that kind of amazing drive and ambition that I no longer really possess anymore. Unfortunately, you do end up to be rather mediocre, which is a fact of life. And you know, that's me. But I do think it's amazing that I was at one point brilliant kid that you were, that you are actually. So, my praising you so much, I kind of lost my thought process. But yeah, you're going to know English in 6 months' time, and that's because you feel this pressure. Right now, you have this crazy culture shock. You've been used to living in a country for over 10 years, born and raised there, South Korea, a very homogenous country. You're not going to understand that word. It's a country with a lot of other Koreans, just like you. In America, it's not the case. There's a lot of diversity, a lot of different people here. And I know a lot of that is terrifying to you right now. The first time you looked at a squirrel in America, you were terrified because it's so much more different looking and so much bigger. Everything is bigger in America. Flies are like this big, where in Korea they're like this tiny. Mosquitoes are bigger, spiders are bigger, and people are definitely bigger. And they look different. People have different colored eyes, different color hair, and in some ways you once thought they look, you know, you were so terrified of looking at especially white people. I don't know why you you know, you were more. It's an interesting thing that you felt more relatable. You know, you when you first chanced upon a black person, you didn't feel terrified or horrified, but to white people you did. That's an interesting thing that you used to feel. I mean, that you feel right now. I meant that I used to feel. But yeah, they look terrifying. They look scary to you. But here's the interesting thing. Eventually, ultimately, you are going to love this country so much. You're going to end up loving America, really holding on to the ideals of American country. And the funny thing is, the really ironic thing is, I mean, you're never going to really believe that you belong to either Korea or country, or Korea or America. You're still going to have this kind of, not necessarily identity crisis, but you're going to be a little bit of limbo, which I still kind of am. But here's the interesting thing is that in 2010, or maybe it was 2011, you're going to return to Korea to visit there for a month. And that will be the first time you go back to Korea after, you know, you have immigrated to America. You're going to go back there, you're going to spend a month there, and it's going to be one of the most, you know, bizarre experience ever, because you're going to feel like you're this foreign alien in that country, more so than you've ever felt when you immigrated to America. Korea is going to become more foreign to you than America was ever to you. So that's the interesting kicker. One of the things that you are going to love about America is the thing that you were terrified about at first, the diversity of the people, of all the different kinds of ideas, different cultures. America is, in some ways, talked about as a melting pot. And I know you even 6 months from now, you're not going to really understand what that term means. But there's all sorts of kinds of different people and different cultures that you can experience in this country, different ideas and differences, opinions. And people are going to be able to argue with each other. That's possible without any kind of, you know, the craziness that goes on in a country like Korea. And, you know, it's weird, but you end up kind of getting along with other Americans more than other Koreans. Your best friends in, you know, junior high, in high school, they turn out to be Mexican, white, of Irish descent. They turn out to be, you know, different races of people. Your current really closest friend is a West Indian. I mean, he's American, but he's black, and he's currently teaching in Japan. Up to this point, I'm 25. Up to this point, from where you are now to me, you're going to end up dating two, you know, you're going to have two ex-girlfriends, and both of those ex-girlfriends are black. One is half Dominican. The girl that you fall in love with in during high school is a white girl of Italian and German descent. You know, it's amazing how much you come to embrace diversity in this country, how much you come to love this country, and how much you come to master the English language. In 6 months' time, you become, you know, conversationally fluent in English. In a year's time, you become really proficient. Your proficiency in English becomes so amazing, in fact, that you end up being bullied in school. A lot of the kids that you have, you know, English second language course with, the ESL classes, a lot of these kids are Japanese immigrants who immigrated to America a year or 2 years before you. And they're about the same age as you, but you learn English quicker and are able to be better at English than them in less time. That gets a lot of people mad. They become really jealous at you, and you're going to experience a lot of bullying in your life, just as you have experienced bullying in Korea. But one of the reasons you experience bullying in New York is because of jealousy, because of the fact that you are, you know, you become so great at English, which I think is really amazing. And of course, as a 10-year-old kid, you don't have the foresight to know that you shouldn't brag about your, you know, proficiency and your accomplishments. So yeah, that ends up creating a lot of enemies in your time. But looking back to you, I think in some ways I look back to you and I'm left a little bit inspired, which is an interesting thing, that I'm inspired by my own self, which is so arrogant and so conceited in so many ways. But I can't deny the fact that to me, I look at you as a really brilliant kid, and I hope to you know, kind of rekindle that ambition and drive in me as I did back in the days. But yeah, that's what I want to say to you now. This has been really interesting talking to myself, but in a different time. So yeah, cheers.